Good morning, or whenever you are watching this, it's morning for me right now. Thank you for tuning in to this version of Mobility Monday, the pre-recorded, not live version. Somehow I got restricted, my account. It had to do with something in another group from like a year ago. I don't even know. I couldn't even figure out what it was. So hopefully I will get that taken care of and I won't be actually banned for 30 days. But anyway, today, Mobility Monday, we are going to focus kind of on the back. But, you know, our shoulders and our hips are connected, right? So those are going to be incorporated too. So we're going to start off lying on the ground. The good news is I can go landscape instead of portrait. So let's take that as the bright side. I'm going to tilt this down a little bit more. Okay. So pretty much always we're going to start off with the pelvic tilt. We're going to get our low back working, kind of bring some blood flow into the vertebrae, the discs, and get our pelvis moving as well. So what we're going to do first, legs are bent. You put your hand here, you feel you have that natural curvature in your spine. So we're going to use our abs, tighten the abs. Our pelvis is going to rotate, so kind of tucking under. We're pressing our low back into the ground. So if you put your hand here, tighten your abs, pull your belly button toward the floor and relax. So you do this with your breath. So breathe in, exhale to contract, inhale, relax. And again, contract. Two more. So at any time, we can do this pelvic tilt in a standing position or a kneeling position as well, where we're going to tighten our tummy, basically putting our low back into neutral. Excuse me, I need to clear my throat. Sorry. And we're tucking our hips under. So this is important to remember. So we're going to start off in this pelvic tilt position. So our abs are tight and our pelvis is tucked under, our hips are tucked under, and we're just going to press up into a bridge. You don't have to come up as high as I'm coming up. Just going to squeeze the glutes, keeping the abs nice and tight, and lower. So you can keep the abs tight. You can keep your spine in neutral here when you touch down and then come back up. Or you can kind of incorporate the pelvic tilt each time. So you're getting a little bit more movement in the lumbar spine, the low back. So you see the difference here where I'm adding this pelvic tilt at the beginning and the end versus let's just keep it tight. Keep the back in neutral, keeping the abs engaged the entire time, okay? So from here, we're gonna do a little rotation. So this one I think feels really good. And basically what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna kind of be pinning our upper body to the ground and rotating our lower body. So we're gonna getting some movement kind of through our mid back, our T-spine, the thoracic spine. So I'm gonna use right and left here just for clarity. I'm gonna have my right leg straight out. My right arm straight out to the side. My left arm is gonna be up in the air and I'm gonna pack my shoulder down, okay? So I'm keeping my shoulder blade in contact with the floor. I'm gonna bring my left leg up to a tabletop position, so bent at 90 degrees, and then slow and controlled, and keeping my left shoulder on the ground, I'm gonna rotate across my body and then back up. So the abs are kind of going to be engaged here, especially when we pull back up to the center. So by keeping our upper body pinned, we're getting this nice rotation through the kind of the middle of our back. If you let it come up, you lose that rotation because you're turning into it. So that's why we're keeping the back down. You might get a little pop in there. I just had one. And this is a great way. When you're feeling really stiff, this is a really great one. Same thing with that, the pelvic tilt and the bridge. our vertebrae, our discs, the discs between the vertebrae get their like nourishment and blood flow through movement. So we are nourishing our spine right now. So we're going to switch sides. So the left leg goes straight, the left arm goes straight out, right arm up, and make a fist as well. Pack that shoulder down into the floor, that shoulder blade. Bring the leg up to tabletop and slowly rotate across the body, keeping that arm, that shoulder blade in contact with the ground. So you'll notice, especially when you switch sides, you'd gotten looser on the other side. So you feel like you can go further than you can and your shoulder's gonna wanna come up. So just stick with the range of motion that you have at that time. And as you go, you should warm up a little bit and be able to go a little bit further. Let's go three more here. Also, if this position feels really good and you kind of want to hang out in more of a static stretch here, what you could do is grab like some couch cushions or something, or maybe like a foam roller, and just kind of put it here under your leg so you can just kind of rest in this position. You could do that as well. Okay, we're going to flip over onto our belly. And we're going to do a prone cobra. So prone just means that we're on our belly and we're going to rear up like a cobra. So we've done the low back, we've done the mid back. Now we're coming to the upper back, which is so, so important for our posture. So I'm going to adjust the thing real quick. Small adjustment. Okay. So lay with your arms out to the side. Don't look up at the camera. Watch me do it. And then when you actually do it, your face is going to be more like this. Okay. So kind of chin tucked, lift the arms up off the floor. We're going to pull the our arms together, squeeze the shoulder blades together. Keep the abs tight here. Okay. Like you're trying to pull your belly button up off the floor. And we're trying to touch the back of our hands together. Hold that. So we're squeezing our shoulder blades back and down, keeping the chin tucked and the abs tight. Hold this for 3, 5, 10 seconds. Come back down and repeat. Come back, I'm gonna make sure my abs are tight, pulling that belly button off the floor, squeezing my shoulder blades back and down. Two more. Keep those abs tight. Make sure we're not shrugging the shoulders. We're squeezing the shoulder blades together, but also pulling them down toward your back pocket. So you might hear me say sometimes, put your shoulder blades in your back pockets. That's what you want to be thinking about when you're sitting at your desk, when you're standing, especially when you're doing a back exercise like this. Okay, so we need to stretch out the low back a little bit so we're gonna stretch out the low back a little bit. Just do a nice cat-cow kind of position because we were definitely just doing some extension there in our back. So come up to all fours and we're just gonna round the back, kind of tuck your tailbone in because we're squeezing the abs here. And then actually, instead of going back up into the cow position, we're just gonna come back to neutral, okay? So just tuck it under, we're stretching like a cat, kind of push through your hands, through your shoulders, tuck the tailbone under, squeezing the abs tight, like someone's pulling my abs up through my back, or my belly button up through my back. And then just return to neutral. Let's just do two more here. This is just to kind of counteract that extension, that arching in our back that we were just doing. One more. While we're here, we might as well work our shoulder blades in a little bit of a different way. So we're going to stay in this all fours position. What we're going to do is we're going to do, it's like shoulder blade push-ups basically. So our elbows are going to stay straight. You're going to want to bend your elbows, but keep them straight. And we're just going to lower our chest between our arms, squeezing our shoulder blades together. So it looks like this. Your chin is going to be, your head is in nice alignment with your spine, chin tucked. Abs are tight. So I'm just lowering down. So I'm squeezing my shoulder blades at the top, keeping my abs tight. Trying to pull the shoulders away from the ears. You put those shoulder blades in your back pockets and then push back up. So we're going to push back up into that like that cat position. Okay. And then lower back down, abs tight, shoulder blades back and down. Press back up. So we're taking the shoulder blade through one of its ranges of motion. It has multiple. And we're working the muscles surrounding the shoulder blade. Squeeze, shoulders away from the ears, abs are tight, press back up. So when you get really good at this, you can actually do shoulder blade push-ups. You might hear them called scap push-ups, as the scap is in the scapula. So to do that, you would get into a plank or a push-up position. See, I'm pushing up through kind of my mid upper back here. And you do the same exact thing, we just have more resistance because it's more the body weight. So you do the same thing, abs tight, elbows straight, sink down, shoulder blades back and down. Okay, so that would be just a more advanced version of that. So even though I can do those, I tend more to do it from my knees. Just because I have a little bit more control over it and I have less tendency to want to shrug my shoulders and for other muscles to come in and help. Final movement, just to get the shoulders overhead. Our shoulders do lots of things. So just sit in a comfortable position for you. We're going to start our elbows off like a W, or start our arms off like a W. You can do this standing. You can do this sitting at your desk, or take a little movement break and stand up near your desk. You can do this against a wall, and I can show you a different time how to super intensify this and add your abs to it even more so. But we're going to get our arms overhead. So big component here is keeping the abs tight the entire time, because when we reach our arms overhead, we're going to want to arch our back, okay? And we don't want that. So we're gonna start off like a W, elbows are close to the body, and then we're trying to, as if we're pressing against the wall behind us. And we're gonna raise up to like a Y position. So I'm pushing back, my abs are tight, and then I come back down. I'm keeping this tension in my back this whole time, okay? Like I'm pressing against the wall. So I'm actually shaking a little bit right now. Keep breathing as you do it. We're keeping the abs tight, especially as your arms go overhead and you try to push back, your back is gonna wanna help. So you gotta keep your abs tight to prevent that. And when we come back, we're making sure we're squeezing our shoulder blades back and down. And then we raise it up. One more here. Keep that pressure back. Keep the abs tight. Back and down. Relax. You should be in really nice posture now. We've really opened up the chest and activated the rear shoulder and the upper back now. Thank you for joining me. Have a great day. Let me know if there's anything in particular that's kind of bugging you body-wise. Let me know and we will address it in a future Mobility Monday. Hopefully we'll be able to go back to live soon, but I suppose there are benefits from being able to do more of a pre-recorded version. So thanks guys for watching. Have a great week.